Hello students, now we have discussing the practical based on the working of spanning tree algorithm by varying the priority among the switches. So first we will see the concept of spanning tree algorithm. It is basically used to calculate the sum of weights of all the edges in a tree. There are many trees are used, but minimum spanning tree is basically used where the cost is minimum among all the spanning trees. There also can be many minimum spanning trees. So when the spanning tree algorithm determines the port is to be in the forwarding states, and the following steps are happen. The port is put into the listening state while waiting for protocol information suggesting it should go to the blocking state. The port is waits for the expiration of protocol or forward delay timer that moves the port to the learning state. In the learning state, the port continues to block framing forwarding at it learns network host to location information for the forwarding database, and the expiration of protocol forward delay timer moves the port of the forwarding state. Both learning and forwarding are enabled while the port is in forwarding state. Because the spanning tree port states are is basically performed in five steps, that is called as blocking, listening, learning, forwarding and disable. So this loop can be created for transferring the packets through the LANs, different LAN switches. So switches must allow the frame lifetime to expire from frames that have been forwarded using the topologies. So when STP is enabled, every bridge and switch to the network starts in the blocking state and transition to the listening and learning state. If properly configured, the ports then stabilize to the forwarding or blocking state until change is required made. So spanning tree algorithm is basically used the spanning tree protocol. It is used to prevent the looping within a network topology. It is created to avoid the problems that arises when computers are compared the ability to use shared telecommunication path over a local area network. When too many computers try to send at the same time, overall the network performance is affected and can bring all traffic is near to halt. So STP spanning tree protocol prevents the conditions known as bridge looping. It reduces the likelihood of looping in a LAN divided into two or more network segments with a device called a bridge connection. Any two segments, each message goes through the bridge. He will create the bridge by using the different switches and make a path from the different bridges. So each message goes through a bridge before going to send a intended destination. The bridge determines whether the message is for the destination with the same segment senders or for the other segment senders, and forwards accordingly. A bridge looks the destination address and based on its understanding of two segments, forward its write path. The benefit of network segmentation is the amount of competition for use of network path is reduced by half. Segment has the same number of computers and possibility of network coming to halt specifically reduces. So here four switches are taken and these switches make the bridges between transmitting the messages from different paths from first switch to the switch 3. So made the connection and just using the spanning tree protocol over the LAN, it will transmit the packets and capture the packets. So it will just click on auto capture play. It will start it to send the packets from the different bridges, that is nothing but different parts which is created from start sending the source and destination. So to do this, they have a separate path connection. There is a separate path connection for source to destination. That is, first path is choosing from 0 to 2 and second path is choosing from 0 to 1. Just between the bridge in which they exchange the information using the bridge protocol data units, our data message exchange across the switches with an extended LAT that uses the spanning tree protocol. So when you click on this spanning tree protocol, He will show the inbound PDU details. They are showing the Ethernet, MAC addresses of source and destination, and STP BDPU, that is nothing but breach protocol data units, will show the port ID, MAX, age, forward, delays, then breach. It will check the breach ID from the number of switches among transmitting the data. So this breach protocol data units are data message exchange across switches with an extended LAN that uses the spanning tree protocol. The program in each breach that allows to determine how to use protocol is known as spanning tree algorithm. It is specifically constructed to bridge loops. The algorithm is responsible for a breach using only a most efficient path when faced with multiple paths. And it is, if any one path is fails, then again it recalculates the networks, find the best route. So allowing the breach to learn the network through experience is known as transparent breaching. Means that bridging does not require the setup by an administrator. Thank you.